Hi, my name is Abby Lynch, and I'm the Teen Services Librarian here at the Brookfield Library, back for another week of Teen Book Talks. I hope you are staying cool on these hot days and enjoying the end of your summer vacation and getting ready for school or gearing up for fall and staying safe and staying healthy. Since it's the end of summer, today's books are all 200 pages or under. Things are winding down, school's starting up, and you may find you don't have as much time or energy to focus on reading, or sometimes you're just not in the mood to read a giant 500-page, 1,000-page doorstop of a book, and you want something a little shorter. Page count does not equal quality, so I'm here today to recommend some short books for you. You can always find these books in person at the library, or they can be placed on hold online at brookfieldlibrary.org or by calling 203-775-6241, and we are still offering curbside pickup, so that's available for you if you'd like it. Let's get started with our first short book. It's Fly Girls from the Fly Girl series, Lux, The New Girl by Ashley Woodfolk. Lux Larson is on a spree. Ever since her dad left, she's been kicked out of every school that would take her, and this is her last chance, Harlem's Augusta Savage School of the Arts. If this doesn't work, Lux is off to military school, no questions asked. That means no more acting out, no more fights, and definitely no boyfriends. Focus on her photography and make nice friends. That's the deal. Enter the Fly Girls, three students who have it all together. The type of girls Lux needs to be friends with to stay out of trouble. And after charming her way into the group, Lux feels she's on the right track. But every group has their secrets, including Lux. And when the past starts catching up with her, can she keep her pace as a fly girl? So that's Lux, The New Girl, and it's the first book in this Fly Girl series by Ashley Woodfolk. They're all about similar length, so they're all pretty slim. If you end up liking them, there's more for you to read, and I'm pretty sure they each follow a different one of the characters' perspectives. So that's Lux, The New Girl by Ashley Woodfolk. Next up is one for our mythology fans, or for fans of poetry or novels in verse, and that's Bull by David Elliott. See the story of Theseus and the Minotaur in a whole new light. Minos thought he could pull a fast one on me, Poseidon, god of the sea, but I'm the last one on whom you should try such a thing. The nerve of that guy, the balls, the audacity. I am the ocean, I got capacity, depths, darkness, Delphic power. So his sweet little plan went big time sour, and his wife had a son born with horns and a muzzle, who ended up in an underground puzzle. What is it with you mortals? You just can't seem to learn. If you play with fire, babies, you're gonna get burned. David Elliott turns a classic on its head in form and approach, updating the timeless story of Theseus and the Minotaur for a new generation. A rough, rowdy, darkly comedic young adult retelling in verse, Bull will have readers reevaluating one of mythology's most infamous monsters. So that's Bull by David Elliott. Next up, we have The Things She's Seen by Anne Boleyn and Ezekiel Que Molina. Nothing's been the same for Beth Teller since the day she died. Her dad is drowning in grief. He's also the only one who's been able to see and hear her since the accident. But now she's got a mystery to solve, a mystery that will hopefully remind her detective father that he is still alive, that there is a life after Beth that is still worth living. Who is Isabel catching, and why is she able to see Beth too? What is her connection to the crime Beth's father has been sent to investigate? A gruesome fire at a home for troubled youth that left an unidentifiable body behind. What happened to the people who haven't been seen since the fire? As Beth and her father unravel the mystery, they find a shocking and heartbreaking story lurking beneath the surface of a small town, and a friendship that lasts beyond one life and into another. So that's The Things She's Seen by Anne Boleyn and Ezekiel Que Molina. Next up, we have one for our adventure fans, and that's Found by Joseph Bruschak. A teenage survival expert finds all his skills tested as he's pursued through the Canadian wilderness by men determined to silence him. On his way to teach at Camp Seven Generations, a native outdoor school, Nick witnesses a murder and then is thrown off a train. Remembering and using the teachings of his Abenaki elders will prove to be the difference between life and death for him. Although his pursuers have modern technology to help them, Nick has something even more useful. In addition to the skills he's learned, he has an ally in the natural world around him. Found, like the famous story, The Most Dangerous Game, is a tale that focuses on being hunted until a way can be found to become the hunter. So that's Found by Joseph Bruschak. Next up we have Justine by Forsyth Harmon. Summer 1999, Long Island, New York. Bored, restless, and lonely, Allie never expected her life would change as dramatically as it did the day she walked into the local Stop and Shop. But she's never met anyone like Justine, the store's cashier. Justine is so tall and thin, she looks almost two-dimensional, and there's a dazzling mischief in her wide smile. Her smile lit me up and exposed me all at once, Allie admits. Justine was the light shining on me and the dark shadow it cast, and I wanted to stand there forever in the relief of that contrast. Allie applies for a job on the spot, securing a place for herself in Justine's glittering vicinity. As Justine takes Allie under her wing, Allie learns how best to bag groceries, what foods to eat and not to eat, how to shoplift, who to admire, and who she can become outside of her cold home, where her inattentive grandmother hardly notices the changes in her. Allie becomes more and more fixated on Justine, reshaping herself in her new idol's image, leading to a series of events that spiral from superficial to seismic. And if you like the illustration on the cover, there are more illustrations done by the author throughout the book. Kind of breaks up the text a little bit. So that's Justine by Forsyth Harmon. Last up, we have one for our sci-fi fans, and that's Stormbreaker by Anthony Horowitz, which is the first book in the Alex Rider series. They told him his uncle died in an accident. He wasn't wearing a seatbelt, they said. But when 14-year-old Alex finds his uncle's windshield riddled with bullet holes, he knows it's no accident. What he doesn't know yet is that his uncle was killed while on a top-secret mission. But he is about to, and once he does, there's no turning back. Finding himself in the middle of terrorists, Alex must outsmart the people who want him dead. The government has given him the technology, but only he can provide the courage. Should he fail, every child in England will be murdered in cold blood. And that's Stormbreaker by Anthony Horowitz. Again, this is the first book in the Alex Rider series. These ones do get a little bit longer as the series goes on, but they're all pretty quick reads. If you end up liking it, there's more for you there. So those are our short books today. I hope there's something in there that you are interested. I think I'm going to do a long book video too. So if huge doorstop books are more your speed, I'll have one of those coming up shortly. If you didn't see anything you liked today, please feel free to visit our website under the Teen Services tab and fill out a personalized reading suggestion request, and I'll put together a little book list for you tailored specifically to your interests. And until next time, have a great week.